Dr. Shaibal Chakraborty from Calcutta. I am responsible for GD Hospital and Diabetes Institute in Calcutta. We are happy to say that we see 3,000 patients, new patients in diabetes per month, but I'm sorry to say we are not achieving a proper diabetes control. HbA1c is more than 8% as per our internal audit some time ago. So why is that in the age of SGLT2, GLP-1 and so many other DPP-4 and so many other drugs, we are unable to achieve the desired blood sugar control? Nowadays, we are very much, everything should be evidence-based. Even in history, evidence-based, medicine, evidence-based. So in the era of evidence-based medicine and plethora of guidelines, we are sometimes confused and we go through the motion. Perhaps we are not giving enough time to our patients. So we should give more patients, more time, so that the current thinking that is doing the rounds is shared decision making, personalized care, and empowering the patients. So we need to talk. My guideline may say a drug is good for this, my ex patient, but once we discuss, perhaps it will be an excess of care, it will be some discomfort with the program that patient is not willing to undertake. So we should share that what is the best possible option. Sometimes, because what we want to control the blood sugar, manage the blood sugar so that we achieve an A1C below 7%, and how best it can be achieved. So that has to be personalized for that person. Also, sometimes we find a new indication for a rather old medicine or new medicine for something else. Perhaps that can be added, though it is not in the guideline. So all these things need to be discussed and time given to the patient so that patient feel that he is under control. Nobody likes to be dictated something. We do not like it. I do not like it. So patient should feel that he is under control. And while making a shared decision, if I mean diabetes, I as a doctor mean HbA1c less than 7, there is no retinopathy, LDL is less than 70 or like that. But patient might have other issues. For him, maybe diabetes means he cannot have his desserts at night. So these things has to be discussed threadbare, brought out. The other day I was talking to a patient. He came that his previous consultant was very strict. He's unable to cope with it. So with shared decision making, some leeway here and there, how can we make the program, I will not say treatment, therapy, I will say the program to manage myself better, much more tolerable. That is the need of the hour, and only then we will be able to achieve at the micro level what we want. At the population level, each brick makes a building. So if I control individually, give more time, so if my individual patients are getting more less than 7, so as a whole, my people, my country will achieve a better blood sugar control and thereby not having those complications. We are now bombarded by retinopathy, cardiac infarct, renal failure, peripheral vascular disease, diabetic neuropathy. But when it was time to stitch so that stitch in time saves 9, we didn't do that with our patients. So that is my thinking. I like to do that, and I will say, since we are in the profession for a length of time, our junior peers, I would like to say them that spend time with the patient, empathize with the patient. I think the key word, magic word would be what I would do if I had diabetes. And I like my dessert. I am a lazy guy. I would like to watch movies sitting in a couch. So what I would have done if I have diabetes, so that I can empathize with the patient more and give a more fruitful program so that he can control or she can control his diabetes. and we should pick an opportune time to motivate people. So like pregnancy diabetes is one opportune time to motivate a person, a lady, to have control of her diabetes for the lifetime. Like that, even in a person's life, what makes them tick to stick to the program? So that we'll have to find out, so that if we can stimulate those thoughts in that patient, he will stick to his own program and not lose in follow-up, or maybe will be managed to able to manage his blood sugar much more effectively, be it insulin therapy, be it some complex regimen. When we were doctor, we had only three treatments: insulin, sulfonylurea, metformin. Now we know more about the pathophysiology of diabetes, and we have n number of drugs for that. But still, we are far away from achieving a blood sugar control of A1C less than 7 in our country. Recently concluded one study, take control, showed the least possible was average was 7.9 something from one city in south. I don't remember the name now, but everywhere it is more than 8. So we are definitely failing, and personalized care, shared decision making, empowering the patients to manage their diabetes, spending some friendly time with our patients is the need of the hour. Thank you.
Insights from the world's best medical minds. You are watching TheRightDoctors.com.